it's like to be inside where the royals lived and entertained. Well, I'm here on the last of the royal lines. It was the Britannia that was decommissioned in 1997?
1997.
Okay, and we're here in Edinburgh, Scotland, right on the docks, but I'm visiting with Roger Moran, who is the, what would you say, are the...
Visitor assistant to Guide on Board.
Extraordinaire, I would say.
It's kind of you to say.
Roger, one of the things that so surprised me, as I'm sure it would every other American, is the utter simplicity of this royal yacht, which was their home at sea. Mm. Tell us a little bit about why you feel that it was so simple.
Well, so simple. The Royal Yacht Britannia is the last in a long line of 83 royal yachts since the reign of Charles II in the 1600s. So this country has a long, long line of royal yachts. This particular one was launched in 1953. Not long after Queen Elizabeth received her crown, the new queen. This is a time when we're only 7 years or so after the end of the Second World War, so Great Britain is going through a time of austerity, very much a culture of make, do and mend. And this ran through the royal family for a long, long time also. So Britannia was no exception. The good thing about Britannia is it's the first new royal residence in a long, long time. A long, long time. If you think about it, you had Buckingham Palace, Windsor mm-hmm. Castle. These already existed for a long period of time before the latest generation of royals were welcomed to them.
Wow.
But Britannia was the first blank canvas where the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh could stamp their own mark on it.
And their mark, in this case, was a very simple one.
Absolutely, very, very simple. The Queen wanted, and the Duke of Edinburgh wanted, somewhere where in times of relaxing, they could relax in an environment that they had an influence over. So what they wanted was an understated elegance, a quiet country house, relaxed feel. And this is where you can see the design influences of the Queen and Prince Philip. The first designs were created, the interior designs, by a chap called Patrick McBride, in conjunction with John Brown, the shipbuilders who built Britannia. But these were rejected by the Queen at the time as being too grand and too fussy.
She said that, so she just asked them to tone it down.
She asked them to tone it down, and they employed the services of Sir Hugh Casson, who was involved heavily with the exhibition in London in the early 50s. And Prince Philip was very, very impressed with his work, Sir Hugh Casson. So he was taken into the fold and gave the royals what they wanted. This was his work. This is what you see now.
I have to say, I actually feel very comfortable on board. Before we go, just share with some of the public some of the heads of state that were actually coming here, sitting in this room and meeting with the Queen and her family.
Well, absolutely. And this is part of the beauty of Britannia. And this is what gives Britannia its soul. It's the people in whose footsteps you are walking. Winston Churchill, for example, in 1954.
He was here?
Winston Churchill was on board the Royal Yacht Britannia. Nelson Mandela, Ranjit Gandhi, a host of American presidents, the Reagans, Ronald and Nancy spent their 40th anniversary on board Britannia. And Nancy Reagan played this Walmart baby grand piano.
I didn't know she played the piano.
She did. She played this very piano. And they spent the 40th anniversary on board Britannia.
Nice.
Eisenhower, President Ford, Margaret Thatcher. A lot, not to mention.
And the Clintons.
And the Clintons.
Too.
And
I think I saw a room.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah. We have Frank and Nancy Sinatra.
Well, that obviously means something.
That's right. Noel Coward, famous playwright, played this piano also during Princess Margaret's honeymoon. He was invited on board and asked to sing for his supper.
Beautiful. Well, I guess before we close, there was just one thought that I had, and it was a remark you made similar to the question that I came up with here, is that it does not necessarily take a lot of outward display in order to share your own refinement. But you said it in a different way, didn't you?
I said it slightly flippantly, but you cannot buy style.
Okay, that's
what
you said.
You cannot buy style. And this style here, this design, with the influence, of course, of the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh through Sir Hugh Casson, is quietly understated. And it's no wonder that the Queen did say about Britannia, it's the one place where she could truly relax.
Very good. Well, if you are thinking about your own royal residence, maybe you would like to design it in a way in which you, too, could truly relax. I know I feel it here. Well, Roger, Moran, thank you so much for inviting me in behind the, what'd you say? Behind the barrier.
This is behind the barrier.
I'm right here where it matters. This has been Maura with Roger right here on the Britannia, and we're here for you. Bye-bye now.